Now we continue our Eight on Your Side series on food allergies. Tonight we take a closer look at peanut allergies, which can be deadly. Often the way you find out that a child has it is when they eat peanuts or a food containing peanuts.
Oh, that's what happened to a young Lancaster County girl. Medical reporter Susan Shapiro has her story.
Kira Tran was 13 months old when she had a severe reaction while eating a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Within minutes, her whole face was swollen, and it just progressed. Her entire body was covered in hives and swollen.
It turned out she was allergic to peanuts. She tested off the charts.
Her allergy is so severe, if she ate something that was made at a place where peanuts are processed, it could cause her to go into anaphylactic shock, and then she could have a fatal reaction.
Happy birthday to you and many more.
Kira is now celebrating her fifth birthday. The shy girl is in preschool at Our Mother of Perpetual Help in Ephrata.
We have to keep this with us at all times.
Her teachers keep this epinephrine pen at the ready. The medication can be used should Kira have an allergic reaction.
It was such a big change because I had never had to deal with this before as a teacher.
I'm just going to take a listen to you.
Allergy doctor Laura Fisher says it's important to take a peanut allergy seriously, but she doesn't think children need to be isolated.
I'm not a big fan of the peanut free tables. I think the stigma that it attaches to children, especially at that young age, is probably a little bit more damaging than the risk of peanuts.
Grocery shopping is very time-consuming for the Tran family. They read each and every label to make sure the product does not contain peanuts and was not made in a facility where peanuts are processed.
It's in items that you wouldn't expect, like jelly beans, plain vanilla ice cream, pretzels. It's everywhere.
What kind do you want to buy? Chocolate.
Kieran, her classmates celebrated her birthday with Hostess Zingers, something her mother knows is a peanut-free treat.
The only way to keep her safe is to make sure she doesn't eat anything that has peanuts or were made in a place where peanuts are processed.
Susan Shapiro, On Your Side, News 8.
Dr. Fisher says only one child in five will outgrow a peanut allergy. Susan's special reports continue tomorrow with a look at celiac disease. That's an allergy to gluten, a protein found in wheat, barley, and rye.